What foods can a teenager cook for his parents to help their depression? Think of the favorite meal your mother made for you and make them that. Tell her why it's so special. I'm really sorry you're going through this. My own mom suffers from bouts of depression too, and it's very hard. Sad face. I talk to her about special memories from my childhood and it seems to help. Edit, woke up this morning to a bunch of replies and more gold than I know what to do with. Thank you so much everyone, but please, call your mom instead and tell her how awesome she is. Literally anything. Depression can be so draining that it's exhausting to do daily activities, like cooking dinner. Just simply supporting them in the way you are is bound to help. You sound like a great kid. I hope you're well and that your parents start feeling like themselves soon. Okay, so, I'm a parent and I struggle with depression and mental health problems, and honestly, I think even if I just knew my kid had asked this question and was trying to think about how to take care of me, it would mean the world to me. Well, at the moment he's only 13 months old, so I would also be pretty astonished, but you know what I mean, but I would also be a little bit worried, and I would want my kid to know that it's not their job to fix, or even help, my mental illness. And I'd want to make sure that they were okay, and not taking on too many responsibilities that they weren't really old enough to cope with. So, since you already have a bunch of good suggestions and recipes in this thread, I'm going to just suggest that you make sure you're looking after yourself as well as your parents, and that you ask for help if you need it. Good luck with everything. Also, pasta. It's easy, it's good comfort food, most people like it, and you can vary the sauce sides to include protein and veg. Edit, thank you so much to everyone who's replied with really nice things or messaged me offering to talk, etc. You're all lovely people. I'm actually doing okay mental health-wise right now, but I appreciate it a ton. I'm sure they would appreciate anything you cook them as long as you put time and effort into it. Something they consider comfort food. It's different for everyone, but start with the classics. Chicken pot pie, for instance. This post breaks my heart. I wish I had an answer for you, but the truth is we can't fix someone else's depression at any age. Good on you for trying, that's what humans do. But if it doesn't work, don't blame your chicken soup. Depression is a bear. Someone else can chime in on whether this pasta dish can help with depression, but here's my adulting recipe for 3-bowl pasta. 3-bowl because you will go back for seconds, and thirds, adulting because I made it up right after college. 1 box of pasta, go with a thicker pasta, like ziti or rigatoni, cook it to the box's instructions, but save some of the water. Also, salt the fuck out of your water. People say it should be like seawater, but those people have no idea how much salt is in seawater. It's around 1 cup of salt per gallon of water for seawater. Don't go that hard, but way more than a pinch. Onion soup mix. Green pepper and red pepper. Garlic. Olive oil. Parmesan cheese. Here's the instructions, start the pasta water. Chop up the peppers, cut them into long strips. Heat a pan to a bit past medium. When hot, pour in a tablespoon or so of olive oil, then the peppers. Stir them around occasionally to cook them. At some point your pasta water is boiling and you have added a lot of salt, and you can cook the pasta to the box instructions. Keep at the peppers. When they are less firm, throw in a clove of garlic, minced. I buy the pre-minced kind because I'm lazy. Whenever you're happy with the peppers, turn them off and remove from heat. When the pasta is done, get at least 2 cups of the water out, and then strain. In a big bowl, pour in about 1/4 cup of your pasta water and stir in the onion soup mix, 1 packet. Then pour in the pasta and the peppers. This is going to be a thick sauce, probably too thick, so add more of the pasta water until you think it's right. When it's to your liking, plate it up, and allow your guests to add as much cheese as they like. It all takes about 20 minutes to make, and is really simple. You can add butter or whatever if you want it creamy. Throw in some green onions if you feel like. You can also use onion, mushroom soup mix. That's a bit different, but you do you. Edit, I love mushrooms to the point where I have been told I shouldn't recommend them, hence the last line not really recommending them, but I would add a shit ton of mushrooms to this about halfway through the pepper cook, sliced thin. If you want the mushrooms to be more earthy, slice them thicker, or bake them really thick, but that's making the dish more involved, and I don't think Op wanted that. Warm and healthy, lots of vegetables. Doing more chores around the house could also be a generous way of showing support. I do as much as I can at home to help my mom's stress. Lasagna. It's an actual science fact that no one can remain sad while eating lasagna. Anything with potassium, black beans are a great source of it. Bananas really don't have that much, a B12 supplement and a multivitamin. Food won't solve depression, but having the building blocks and the energy to work on yourself will go a long way. Plus the daily morning activity of taking your vitamins can be a tool to put yourself in a self-care mindset. Edit, spelling old nostalgic homemade recipes would be a good bet. Any way of getting to know their old favorites? Ripe fresh fruits, especially citrus and blueberries, also young Thai coconuts, and bananas. Hit up the Asian market near you. I got this answer from a friend, spaghetti. They tell me spaghetti tastes 100x better when you're sad. Haven't tested myself, but I trust them. Also, they're probably reading this as well, so hi, this is my kiddo. I am a proud mama. We have been under a lot of stress as a family, and my husband's MS is a struggle, as is my anxiety and hubby's disability and depression. Thank you all for the kind words and recipes. Even the apple egg smiley face, love to all. The happy hormone is most commonly found in chocolate and bananas. So chocolate and banana crepes would be amazing. Stew and dumplings is a good option. Depression is a hard thing. I have had it in the past, and it can be a struggle just to get out of bed in the morning. The fact you want to help and be there is strong. It is not easy to help provide for people in the first place, let alone the change in power dynamic that depression can cause. It isn't what you make that matters. It is that you are willing to help them in any way you can. Just be there to talk if they want to talk, or just hang out with them and bullshit about the weather or about what the dog did today. Your presence matters that most. You being able to go, I want to help you because I care about you, that is what matters. Make them anything and sit down and eat it with them, because being there matters more than anything else. It might be weird at first, but as time goes on it will become easier. Showing someone with depression that you consistently care is one of the strongest things you can do to help with the maintenance of depression. Best of luck, and you can do this. If this is about you and you need someone to talk to about this, PM me. Edit, grammar spelling. Bananas help me a lot with depression. Try a banana peanut butter sandwich or banana Nutella sandwich. Something with iron is also a good idea. Possibly try sautéed or boiled spinach. What questions can I ask in this subreddit to whore internet points? Something with amino acids, zinc, iron, and B vitamins that they like might help. Hidden nutrient deficiencies are often a contributing factor with depression. Mac and cheese. If they ever told you about something their parents made for them, they would definitely appreciate you taking a stab at a family recipe. Edit, TLDR, make it all as colorful as possible. Fruit salad for breakfast, with yogurt and granola. I like grape nuts, personally, but whatever you, they like. Tea and lots of water. Maybe eggs if you're feeling up to it. Lunch, sandwiches on wheat, multigrain bread, make sure to have veggies on there, lettuce and tomato for a traditional sandwich, but you can get creative here depending on your skill level, lots of water. Dinner, a salad kit with the dressing inside makes a pre-dinner salad easy. I like to make rice-a-roni and throw in some chopped up spinach and roasted red peppers with some Italian sausage, but you can put literally anything in there. Load up on the veggies and pick your favorite protein, chicken, ground beef, sausage. So easy and takes me less than 20 minutes to make. You got this. Keep it easy. For me and my depression, having a ritual, same breakfast every morning, was so helpful and became important, because it felt like I had something I could rely on. I hope this helps you, both these comments as well as the ability to do this, and the ritual of it. Just don't put too much pressure on yourself. Keep it easy. I'm gonna guess you're not usually the one cooking? Honestly, a nice slow cooker meal will help the house smell great. Also, very easy prep if you're unfamiliar with cooking. I'd suggest something like pot roast, get a cheap roast, chuck is always tasty, potatoes, carrots, beef broth, and throw them in the slow cooker. Super easy. You can always add more different ingredients like mushrooms, onions, rosemary, etc. if you want to get fancier Prozac pancakes. Spaghetti with Italian bread. Fish. especially salmon, as it's really rich in omega-3. Food can play a big part in depression. Focus on eating fatty fish, like salmon or albacore tuna, in place of red meat. Marijuana and cocaine pancakes should do the trick. Dude, I've been looking through your posts, are you okay? You sound really rough. Make a salad, lettuce and tomato, grill up some chicken and chop it up. Avocado for sure, cucumber and whatever dressing you all like. Salt and pepper to finish it off. Yum, hot brownies.